Hello, my name is Juliana Lescard, and today I'm going to be showing you how to best use a multi-channel pipetter. So here I have a multi-channel pipetter, I have the tips, I have my reagent, and I have my 96 well plate. So the multi-channel pipetter is mostly used to dispense reagents in a 96 well plate all at the same time. So what I'm going to do is I am going to pick up my pipetter, and here you have the tip dispensing button, and you have the volume. You have the volume range that it's displaced in here, and a lot of pipettes you will see it up here. And you have the control button and where the tips are going to go. So this is very typical on all the different brands. They look very similar. So I am going to do now, I'm going to select the volume that I want to use. This one gives me a range between 30 and 300 microliters. I'm going to select 100 microliters. So I'm just going to turn, and I see 100 there, and I'm going to lock it back in place, and now I'm ready to go. So I'm going to come here, and these are the tips that I'm going to use. It's very important for you to select the size of the tips that are that goes with the pipette volume range that you're using, because if you don't do that, if you use a tip too small, you might, when you collect the liquid, it might go into inside your pipette, and you're going to contaminate your pipette. You can also use this tip that has a filter up here. So if you are using something that has microbial contamination worries on it, you can use the one with the filter so you don't worry about contaminating your pipette. So I'm just going to press firmly down and collect my tips. Okay, and now I'm going to go to my reagent, and to do this, you're going to push the control button to the first stop. The pipetter has two stops, one, two. The first one will collect the reagent. The second one will dispense the reagent. So before you go into the solution, you press the button, and then you just immerse your tips in the liquid, and you just release it slowly. And you want to give it another second before you remove the tips from the solution to give it time for the air to catch up. Otherwise, you're going to have bubbles inside the tip and you're not going to have a uniform volume across. And as you can see here, everything looks very even. So you just go to your plate and you just place the tips in there and you just push all the way down. And then you want to just, when you exit the wells, you just want to glide your tip slightly on the sides of the well to get the little droplets that stays on the bottom. It's very important to do that in order to get the correct volume, because if you're doing, let's say, 30 microliters, one drop could be 5 microliters, so you're not getting the volume that you need. So to get that little drop at the bottom of the tip is very important. And then to release, you just push the release button, and that's it.